What's up, YouTube? Capital G here, checking out the brand new D-Hero support that just got revealed, coming out of Burst of Destiny. I guess better late than never. I had honestly lost hope that there would be any Destiny Hero support in this set, despite the name clearly suggesting that there would be some D-Hero support in here, but you know, I guess better late than never. Now, we got three cards to talk about, so I guess you could call this set a small Burst of Destiny, because just three cards, but you know, Destiny Hero players will take it. And I think, you know, maybe Konami wants D Heroes to feel more like a legitimate standalone deck, because Malicious has been used in Hero decks forever, like basically all of them, and it's still being used for Hero players. But of all the heroes that we see being played, you know, you see Elemental, you see Vision and Mast and Evil, but outside of Malicious, you don't really see any D Heroes, so maybe this will change that. Anyways, let's go ahead and check them out. We got a new version of Phoenix Enforcer, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna say, this is gonna take me back, I'm gonna say Phoenix Enforcer was the cover card of Enemy of Justice. I might be wrong on that. Anyways, Destiny Hero, destroy Phoenix Enforcer. This is the new one. Level 8, Dark Warrior Monster, 2500 attack, 2100 defense. Probably the same stats as the old Phoenix Enforcer, but that's fine. Your materials are a level 6 or higher Hero Monster plus Destiny Hero Monster. That's not a problem. Everyone's just going to use Malicious anyway, so you know, that doesn't change anything. The second and third are hard ones per turns. First effect, monsters your opponent control lose 200 attack for each Hero Monster in the graveyard. Second effect, you can destroy one card you control and one card on the field. Third effect, if this card is destroyed by battle or card effect, you can activate this effect. Special summon one Destiny Hero monster from your graveyard during your next standby phase. So I actually did not realize this the first time, maybe even the second time I read this card. Unless I'm missing something, the third effect allows you to just summon this card back. And I think that's obviously like what Konami is going for. Maybe that's what they said on the live stream, but I didn't realize that immediately. The second effect, obviously you got like a Scrap Dragon effect, and that's very good. Without the second effect, I don't think this card would be very strong, but that disruptive effect combined with the fact that, yeah, you just blow this guy up, blow an opponent's card up, and then just reborn this guy with its own effect during your next standby phase, so you're not really losing anything. I think it's actually a pretty strong card. Obviously, Destiny Heroes are all about summoning their fusion monsters with Fusion Destiny, and I like the fact that this gives Destiny Heroes an actual legit grind game, because now you essentially can summon this guy like in your first turn and you kind of have a continuous stream of disruption. You know, during my opponent's turn, I blow this guy up, I blow my opponent's card up. Next turn, he just monster reborns himself. During their turn, I do the same exact thing, and I just endlessly do that. I just endlessly blow him up and, you know, reborn him basically for free, long as they don't banish him or get him off the field some way. Like, I think he's just going to be a card that is in it for the long term. So I definitely like the card. The second card is very good as well. This is Destiny Hero Denier. It's a level 3 Dark Warrior, 1100, 600, and your first effect, your second effect is a hard once per duel. The first effect's a hard once per turn. You don't see that a lot in Yu-Gi-Oh! So if you see hard once per duel, you just assume it's a broken effect, and it actually is. So first effect says, if this card is normal or special summon, you can place one other D-Hero monster that is banished in your deck or in your graveyard on top of the deck. Second effect, if a D-Hero monster other than Denier is on your field or in your graveyard, special summon this card from the graveyard. So obviously, this card just instantly monster reborns itself. So that is super duper crazy, especially considering, I mean, come on, you're going to throw this guy in the graveyard from Fusion Destiny anyways, probably to summon the new Flaming Enforcer. So I think that this card, getting it in the graveyard is going to be easy. You're either going to D-draw it or you're going to use Fusion Destiny. You're going to drop it in the graveyard and then you're going to instantly summon it. Well, if you use Fusion Destiny, that is. So like being able to just freely summon it is very easy. And the first effect a lot of people mentioned, and this is what I thought too, the fact that it can stack a banished monster, like one of your banished D-Heroes, back on top of your deck. Hallelujah. This means we can put our banished Malicious back on top of our deck so we can activate its effect one more time, because we all know Malicious is going to be on that semi-limited list basically until the end of time. It's on the semi-limited list in the OCG, TCG. They're never going to move that card, well, at least for a long time. So this actually, you know, makes it so you can use Malicious or you can get three Maliciouses back like the good old days. So, you know, it's definitely kind of cool. And let's be real, Malicious has been one of the most important hero monsters, or D-hero monsters, forever. I think that, like, your ideal targets for Fusion Destiny, I think they did this in the stream, even in the picture, is, yeah, you drop Malicious, and then you drop Denier, and that's, like, your basic combo. The third card, I don't know if you gotta play this card. Break of Destiny, Normal Trap. Hard once per turn on both of the effects. Target one Destiny and Dragon or one level 8 or higher Destiny hero monster you control. Destroy it, and if you do, skip your opponent's next main phase 1. Second effect, you can banish this card from the graveyard. Add one spell slash trap that specifically lists Destiny and Dragon or one Destiny hero monster's name in its text from your deck to your hand. Except another copy of Break of Destiny. So they almost had me with the second effect, but unfortunately, it has to specifically list a D hero monster. Like, it has to list that monster's exact name in the card text. And that really, really kind of ruins that effect. Because, yeah, if you could just search, like, Fusion Destiny or Destiny Draw, that'd be super good. But guess what? You can't, because those cards don't specifically list a Destiny hero. So it means you have to go for, one of the cards that have, like, Plasma or Destiny and Dragon in the name. You got to go for, like, D-Force or something like that. People might not play those cards, so playing this means, like, you're already committed to those cards. I don't know if I like that, honestly. The first effect also only works when you have a big D-hero monster on field, like one of the fusions. That means it's automatically just situational. And when you look at, like, the new Phoenix Enforcer, he can already blow himself up anyway. So, like, I mean, skipping my opponent's main phase 1, I guess that's cool, but I don't know. I don't really think the card's all that good, honestly. The first two cards, I think, are crazy good, but the last one, I'm not playing that card. Anyways, whatever you guys think of the new D-Hero support, you leave that in the comment section below. Thank you guys for watching, as always.